Hello and welcome back to another episode of FFBE. So today we're back in Dark Vision 12, which is equal to Dark Vision 14 on JP server. For real, it's not quite similar because the final boss is changed. They changed from Dark Metal Gargantua to a Dark Asura. But we're not gonna do that final stage in this video. Okay, for the first stage, this is a physical domain of Iron Dark. Boss is human-type monster. This team needs 30% or more for fire light resistance, and there's some special unit that don't need that, so I will explain later. The idea to build this team is Masuka and Edgar. They will be my main damage dealer, so I will give them the best gear that I have. Alright, let's start with the first unit. For Masuka, her normal form, she needs 30% or more for fire light resistance and some limit fill gear because you need to fill her limit gauge before turn 3. She's quite different for other dragoon because she prefers true double hand. And yes, true double hand is the best in slot for her, especially if you have her as TMR. If you want to use her in 2 dual wheel form, you need to sacrifice so many slots. That's not worth it. For her breath form, in this form you don't need 30% light resistance, you just need only 30% fire resistance, and the rest of her gear just give her a human killer some damage, and don't forget to give her Xavier Lightning as TMR. As you can see here, she has only 50% fire resistance and don't have any light resistance. With this build, she had 250% human killer, 800% jump damage. Next unit is Asta and Cleo. Their normal form just need only elemental resistance. You don't even need some limit fill gear because we have a plenty of time to fill their limit gauge. On their breath form, just give them a human killer limit burst damage and their attack. Because they are true double hand unit, you can give them a Xavier Lightning as TMR to increase damage by a little bit. For this build, they have 300% human killer and 285% limit burst damage. Edgar will be another jumper here. On his normal form, he needs 30% or more for fire light resistance. He can fill his limit gauge, so you don't need to give them those limit fill gear. On his spare form, give him human killer jump damage and his attack. And don't forget, he also needs 30% fire resistance. He is similar to Masuka, so he don't need light resistance. Just only 30% fire resistance is enough. With this build, he has 225% human killer and 800% jump damage. As you can see here, only fire resistance, no light resistance. Next is Madame Ideal. She will be a key here to give us Dark Imbued, Dark Modifier, and 300% attack buff. On her normal form, and give her Judgment Stuff because we need to dispel. And don't forget to give her Elemental Resistance and Dual Cast. On her bare form, she will be a chainer, so just give her a human killer and her attack. She will chain Stardust Ray with Gilgamesh, and don't forget she also needs 30% or more for fire and light resistance here. Last of all, Legan will be a physical evasion and provoke tank. Yes, they can be, because they will be in this form until kill turn. We're gonna do setup, do everything here. One thing that's very important, don't forget to give them 10,000 needle. So this is the key for we don't need light resistance on our dragoon. And their bear form, give them as usual, limit burst damage, human killer and their attack. They have 250% human killer and 295 limit burst damage. Gilgamesh is very good here. So he will be a chainer. So he gonna chain start out way in normal form with Madame Edel. So give him a human killer and his attack. I don't have that much human killer here, so I give him a Esper stat buff. For his breath form, you can gear anything because we're not gonna use any damage here. In this form, he will do a 85% break and 130% dark imperil. Okay, that's all. Let's go. Alright, for turn 1, we start with elemental resistance buff. Asta and Creom use light resistance buff from Alexander. Gilgamesh use buff Phylaga from Carbuncle. And for the rest, they don't have anything to do, so let's... No, I'm not gonna guard, so let's attack to generate some limit crystal. For Odin attack battle, all the fire attack is magic, and all the light attack is physical. You can use another strategy by relying on those. Okay, for turn 2, we're gonna do the 100 chain score here, so let's triple cast all units. Masuka, Madame Edel, Edgar, and Gilgamesh will triple cast their Stardust Ray Chaining move. Asta, Creom, and Legend Last will triple cast their Absolute Winner of Equity Chaining move. Alright, send them together. Don't worry, chain is not gonna break because we have so many unit chain together. And that is 100 chain score. We have to do this first because on the kill turn we are unable to reach 100. Turn 3 is a free turn. If you are unable to fill Masuka and Edgar limit gauge, so fill it here. But if you already fail, so I will guard all of them. Don't worry about last or legend limit gauge because Madame Edel able to fail it for us. Alright, this is the first imperil. So that's why you need to dispel if you go beyond turn 4. Start with Madame Edel, let's use dual cast dispel card. Same as usual, click on her and click on our team. Okay, everything gone. Let's do a setup for our Dragoon. So shift Masuka to her breath form and use limit burst. Do the same thing on Edgar, shift him to breath form and use his limit burst. And because we did spell, we need to buff elemental resistance again. Use a light resistance from Asta Creo and fire resistance from Gilgamesh. Last will Legan need to use 10,000 needles here. As I said before, all the fire damage is magic and all the physical damage is light element. So we don't need light elemental resistance because we have one stack mirror. See? Zero damage without light resistance. Okay, this is a jump turn, but before we do that, we need to do setup. Let's start with Madame Edel. We're gonna use her Dark Imbue and Dark Amplifier on her cooldown. Madame Encouragement for 300% attack buff. And we need to choose, so I give limit gauge to Last Will and Legend because they don't fulfill that limit gauge. And the final one, just use her cooldown. Asta and Creom will buff 150% human killer. So let's buff everything, so let's use all her cooldown. So they gonna buff 300% attack, limit burst damage, and human killer. Okay, everything ready, so let's use jump on Masuka and Edgar. For Masuka, use her booming jump. and Edgar y o u Figaro jump. Chief Gilgamesh to his brave form. You need to do this beforehand because on the kill turn you need to shift back to normal form for changing Stardust Ray. Alright, we're gonna do a break here. Let's use Secret Sword Art Excalibur. That is 85% break. And Secret Sword Art Muramasa. No? Okay, we're gonna use one by one. So let's use Excalibur Muramasa and Genji Blade. Okay, so Legend don't have anything to do, so just attack or guard him. Okay, turn 6 will be a setup turn for the rest of the party. Let me start with Aksa Cleo. Shift to that breath form. So, we're gonna do a 200% limit burst damage buff here with her Grand Disability. So, let me see skill for a while because I never used them. Let's use Snowstorm Melodia. So this will be a limit burst damage buff. Last one, Legan do his setup for limit burst damage buff too. We don't need attack buff because we get that from Madang Idel, but you still need limit burst damage buff on the cooldown. Idel shift to her brave form and I don't think I need to use something here. I never use her. Sorry about that. So let's guard her. And Gilgamesh, let's refresh break and impel. Oh, one more thing. This is very important. So don't decrease Odin HP to below 80%. If you do that, you will get instant kill for one unit. Try to minimize your damage before kill turn. Okay, for the kill turn, shift Gilgamesh back to normal form and use Stardust Ray Chaining move. Shift Last World Legend and use that Limit Burst. Use Limit Burst on Aksa and Cleo. And Triple Cast Stardust Ray from Madame Idel. Okay, for the order, send Stardust Ray first. After that for a while, send Aksa and Cleo because that Limit Burst is quite long. And after you see 300% on screen, send the rest. Okay, 65, really? 9.8 billion. I have nothing to say here, so why don't you give me? Alright, I will redo the variation, so move on to the second stage. Alright, for the second stage in this area, Dark Diabolos. This is a magical domain of fire and earth. Bought it demon type monster. As usual, we need 30% or more for ice and wind resistance. And some units don't need those elemental resistance on that rare form because we're gonna shift only on kill turn. Next thing is Ram needs to stand on Carbuncle because we need Bar Bisaka. Savior Lightning needs to stand on Death of Selfie because we need Bar Aroka. The idea for this team is focus on Terra and Soul and Dark Fina because they will be our main damage dealer. Soul and Dark Fina will give the rest of the team for 150% demon killer. Terra will do a direct element burst damage. Okay, let's start with the first unit. Shui will be a limit burst finisher and she will do some limit fail on her normal form. On normal form, she needs only elemental resistance. That's all what she needs because we don't need to deal that much damage. On her brave form, gear her for spirit 2 double hand, limit burst damage, and demon killer. You don't need elemental resistance here because we're gonna shift her to brave form only on the kill turn. Okay, for this build she had 225% demon killer, 250% limit burst damage. Ibala will be another limit burst finisher. Her normal form is not that important because we can achieve her to best form at the very beginning of the battle. Her best form needs elemental resistance as usual, and I'm not sure that this gun is better than secondary lot because this gun will provide 75% demon killer, but she not gain any benefit from lot imperil. She needs limit burst damage and high demon killer. She had 250% magic demon killer and 135% limit burst damage. So Andafina will get the best gear for me because there will be a key unit. Their normal form only needs elemental resistance. That only thing they need. And their best form, you don't need any elemental resistance. As you can see here, they don't have wind resistance. And in this form, they need limit burst damage, demon killer, and their magic. With this build, they have 300% demon killer and limit burst damage. They also do a direct element because boss also weak to earth. Ram will be a support and will chain absolute mirror of equity with Xavier Lightning. You only need her HP here. I think 8000 is enough for only single cooldown cast. If she has more than that, it's fine, but 8000 is minimum. For Terra, she will be our main damage dealer. On her normal form, give her a Dragon Brush and Call of the Wild. She needs to fill her limit gauge on turn 2 by herself. So that's why you need to give her a lot of limit fill gear. On her Brave form, gear her as usual. You also need elemental resistance here on Brave form because we need to do a setup. Gear her as usual, evoke damage, evoke magic, and limit burst damage. Xavier Lightning will be a 90% spirit break. On her normal form, gear her for attack. This is the best that I can do for her because, damn, her magic is very bad. She don't have any magic that able to chain with Chaos Wave Awaken. On her bear form, she will stay in here forever until kill turn. So give her a physical evasion and provoke tank. Okay, that's all for the unit. Let's go. We will do a 4 turn kill so we don't need any dispel. Start with Rem. Use Barbisaka for ice resistance. Xavier Lightning used Bar Aoka for wind resistance. For Chui and Ibala, you need to unlock their Quad Cat because we also need to use them for a 100 chain score. So use her cooldown. For Ibala, use only her cooldown so let weakening appear. Don't unlock Quad Cat on Soul and Darkina because they have limit burst damage boost on their cooldown. If you use that, you are unable to use limit burst damage boost on the kill turn. Alright, for turn 2, let's chain first. So hopefully we able to fill Terra limit gauge here. For Shui, let's use Leaping Pawn for limit fill and chain Chaos Wave Awaken. Ibala use any weak Chaos Wave Awaken skill, just use Yami. So when Darfina triple cast their Chaos Wave Awaken chaining move, and Worm dual cast Chaos Wave Awaken chaining skill. With these 4 units, we are able to reach 100 chain. And it fill limit gauge for Terra, so let's use Madwin fill. For Xavier Lightning, let me help her a little bit, so use Surge and Tornado. Why do we need to use those? Because on her limit burst, After you use her limit burst in waveform, it will imbue lightning for 4 elements, and having some impedal might help her a little bit. It's not that much important, but as I say, I'll try. Okay, for turn 3, this is gonna be a setup turn, so let's start with Worm. Use 2 of her cooldown for Lord Imperial and Fill Limit Gauge. Terra shift to her bear form and do a setup as usual. Magitek power, release fire and transburst. For Savior Lightning, we're gonna use let's use her the last unit because I don't want to break to 80%. For Shui, let's use only Lotus Retribution because we do all her cooldown at the very beginning. Ibala also on the same situation. You need only her cooldown. I don't think we need other than that. Darfina and Soul, we're gonna use two of their cooldown. One of them will be Magic Boost and Limit Burst Damage Boost. Another one will be a Demon Killer buff. And the rest gonna be any Chaos Wave Awakening. And the final unit, use Limit Burst on Savior Lightning, so this will provide 90% Spirit Drain. Okay, that 2 turn break is 90%. Very good. Alright, for a kill turn, as you can see here, if you surpass turn 4, you also need someone to dispel Impel. But we're gonna kill here. Shift Chui to her Brave Form and use her Limit Burst. Ibarra, Terra, Darfina and Soul also use their Limit Burst. And don't forget to shift Darfina and Soul to their Brave Form. Rem, we're gonna Triple Cast here because we used cooldown last turn. Triple Cast is still available this turn. So Triple Cast Absolute Mirror of Equity Chaining Moon. Savior Lightning shift back to her normal form and Triple Cast Absolute Mirror Chaining Moon. Okay, for the order, we're gonna send Terra first. After that, 2 seconds send the front line. And 2 seconds after that, send Absolute Mirror of Equity Chaining Moon. Alright. Terra first. Front line and Chainer. He is so tanky. I think we need to rearrange team because damage is not that good. Only 6.8 billion damage. Maybe Faris will help because she has damage and 85% break. But I'll do it later. Alright, that's all for first 2 stages. Maybe I'll do Ashura tomorrow. Alright, thanks for watching and bye.